Here's the difference between real and shared copies in Cubase.
So you can copy a MIDI event in several ways: Command or Control C to copy, Command or Control V to paste, or Command or Control D to duplicate, or hold Option or Alt and drag, or you can drag this handle. And now I have all these copies of my drums, but I actually want to change my hi-hats a little. So I go in, change it, and because these copies are real copies by default, only this one is changing. But if you want all of them to change, you have to make shared copies. You can also do that in several ways. Command or Control K will bring up this repeat dialog, and here you can check shared copies. You can tell by this equal sign that they are indeed shared. You can also drag the handle, but while holding Shift, or click and hold, and then press Option or Alt and Shift, and drag. If you hold Option and Shift first and then click, it's not gonna work, because here in Settings, Editing, Tool Modifiers, you can see that combination is assigned to Set Cursor Position. You can, however, delete this if you want to. So if I go in now and change the MIDI in one event, it's gonna change in all of them. But I can also make one of those unique again so I can edit them separately. To unlink an event, select it, go to Edit, Functions, Convert to Real Copy. And now when I go and delete something, it's only gone in this one. Side note, if you go to Functions in the context menu, this option is not available. But if you need quick access to it, you can always go to Edit, Key Commands, and assign a key to this function. So that's for MIDI. Audio is a bit of a different story. By default, audio copies are shared copies because you're basically using the same audio source file. So if you're editing that source file, for example, when I copy this audio event and I apply processing to one of those, let's do a fade, I'll get this dialog that warns me that multiple events are using the same audio. And they ask me if I only want to apply the processing to the selected event. And if that's the case, I'd have to create a new version. If I don't, all copies with that audio are gonna get the same processing. Same thing in Vary Audio. So let's make regular shared audio copies, and then I'm gonna make this one unique. For audio, you do get this function in the context menu. And if I go into one of the shared copies and change a note, click Continue, then the same edit happened over here. But this one is completely independent. So this is only affecting this unique event. I always want my audio copies to be unique, so in my settings, under Editing, Audio, I select Create New Version on Processing Shared Clips. And then I don't get the dialog. A nice way to work with shared audio events comparable to MIDI events is when you choose Events to Part. You can also find this in the Audio menu. And then you can make shared copies like you would with a MIDI event, and just go in and edit it. You can also cluster multiple audio events and do the same thing.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe and have fun making music.